This just in, breaking news. Lyft goes public and new investors make tons of money. My goodness, has there ever been an IPO so successful? This just in, breaking news. New investors into Lyft absolutely got screwed today. Well guys, today's video is a perfect example of why you gotta go further than just reading the headlines, okay? If you were just going off of what the media says out there, my goodness, you could get a very false interpretation of what actually happened today, okay? Let's go ahead. Lyft went public today, and let's just look at some of these headlines around this Lyft IPO today, okay? USA Today, Lyft stock price opens 20% higher at $87.24 in its NASDAQ debut. If we just look, Financial Times, Lyft shares surge more than 20%. You know, Seeking Alpha, Lyft opens first day up 21%. And these are like the headlines. Google parent company, Alphabet, has just more than doubled its money on Lyft to $1 billion in just 17 months, okay? This is unbelievable. This just seems like, my goodness, you need to get in Lyft stock. Like, look, get into this hype, guys. Like, holy smokes. Look at, everybody's making money. Lyft shares absolutely soared today. What are you doing not in Lyft stock right now? And if you're looking at the headlines, like, that's what you're thinking right now. Google just doubled their money in such a short amount of time on Lyft. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. They're up 20% plus in the IPO, okay? And then you look a little further than what's on the surface and you figure out that, man, you bought into Lyft shares today, you got absolutely destroyed today, okay? You got absolutely destroyed. Let's look at this here, okay? So this morning when Lyft actually went public, meaning like people like you and I could actually buy Lyft shares, okay? Normal, regular folks out there. At that time, Lyft stock was around $86, $87 when it actually came to the market, which means you and I could actually buy shares, okay? Prior to that time, you could not buy shares, okay? Unless you were a massive institutional investor or a huge Wall Street bank, you could not have bought shares prior to that period, okay? The only people that got in on that are the people that are, you know, way up there in the ranks, okay? Not normal folks. You and I just can't go out and buy Lyft shares prior to that period. So when you and I would have gotten a chance to buy those shares, the stock was trading around $86 or $87 roughly, okay? And then what do we see? We see the big banks try to support it as much as they could early on, and then look at that chart. It just goes down and down and down throughout the day until it closes around $78 a share. Meaning, if you bought into Lyft stock today, anytime around that open, or in fact, just anytime in general, which most people are gonna try to buy in that first like 30 minutes to hour once that actually comes to the public markets, because they're like, oh my gosh, they're getting in the hype. You know, I was watching CNBC this morning, I woke up early, not because of Lyft IPO, I just happened to wake up early, I turned on CNBC, they're hyping it out. They had the guy who was like sitting there at the desk, like anybody that watched it, like, you know, it was an exciting time. It was hype, hype, hype. It opens up huge. And if you bought any time during the day, and especially if you bought in that first, you know, half hour to an hour it was open, you got absolutely destroyed today. Let's be quite frank with this, okay? You got absolutely obliterated, all right? Especially if you're doing this as a short-term trade, which a lot of people that try to get in these IPOs, you know, and try to buy in that first 30 minutes to an hour, usually are doing them as trades, trying to hope, you know, the stock keeps shooting up big, that huge that day, or for the next week or something like that. And if we look at the chart, like, it's just an absolute disaster. So basically, if you bought any time, you know, in that early part of when it actually went public, as a normal person could actually buy in, you're down around $8 per share. You lost around $8 per share. And once again, if you were doing this as a one-day trade, you buy in this morning when it goes public, you know, you sell off before the day ends, you were hoping to make a big profit, you just lost $8 per share, okay? So let's do some math around this. Let's just say you bought 100 shares. You know, you're not a huge investor, so I mean, you just bought 100 shares, and that $100, you know, 100 shares times $8 you just lost, you just took an $800 loss in this stock, all right? Let's say you amped it up a little bit. You bought 1,000 shares of the, you know, Lyft's beautiful stock, right? You just lost $8 a share, you lost $8,000. Let's say you really went heavy, you were planning, you thought, man, this stock is gonna shoot up huge. You know, you bought 10,000 shares. You just lost $80,000 on this Lyft IPO, guys. You just lost $80,000. Now, the other question is, let's say, you know, you bought it as a trade. It hasn't obviously worked out. You're down substantially on your position. You're down, you know, anywhere from, you know, let's say a few hundred dollars to maybe a few thousand to maybe tens of thousands, depending on how big of an investor you are out there, right? So you're down significantly on your position, but you're still holding the shares. Well, this is what I call, you know, when you're trying to basically turn a trade into an investment. And this is something that gets a lot of people in trouble very often. They'll try to do something as a trade, okay? A trade and an investment are two very different things. And it frustrates me, like, being on the internet, because I see so many people that are traders try to talk about their investors. They're two completely different things, okay? If you're a trader, whether you're a short-term trader, like a day trader, or a swing trader, or an actual long-term investor, they're all very, very different things, okay? And so some people kind of look at this and are like, dang, man, I try to do this as a trade. I'm still holding my shares. I haven't got out of them yet. Holding them into the weekend now. And should I turn this into an investment? And just generally, that is a bad idea, okay? Almost always, that is a bad idea to turn a trade into investment, because it was never meant to be that in the first place. You bought in this stock hoping the stock would shoot up huge. It obviously went completely the opposite way. It went just nothing but down and down and down throughout the day until it closes down around $8, $9 from where it went public at, when it actually got on the markets to be traded, right? So you've just completely lost a lot of money. And so now if you want to turn this into an investment, that's usually a bad idea in most situations, okay? Because that's not what you intended to do with that. You intended to make this a trade. You intended to get out before the market closed today, or you intended to get out, you know, 2 hours after, you know, the stock had been open, or whatever your plan was. And now if you're all of a sudden planning on holding this long term or something, just saying, like, a lot of times that's a bad idea because you never even planned on doing that in the first place. And here's the thing, if you are buying this as a long-term investment, here's what you're looking at on a valuation. Now, if you're actually buying this as a long-term investment, even if you originally bought it as a trade, now all of a sudden you have to start paying attention to a valuation. Okay, trader momentum and things like that, you don't have to pay attention to valuation. But if you're doing a long-term investment, now we're talking about valuation. And here's what you're getting for Lyft. You are paying a 10x plus sales ratio for those Lyft shares that you bought today, all right? That is a very, 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 very high amount to basically pay for any stock out there. When you're talking about 10x plus sales ratio, guys, that's a huge valuation you're paying for the Lyft company if you're thinking about this as a long-term investment. Number two, they are absolutely bleeding money right now, okay? If you're thinking about turning this into a long-term investment, you're paying nosebleed valuation for this company. And the fact is, around Lyft right now, they're losing a lot of money, somewhere around $800+ million they lost last year. 2019, I can almost guarantee you they're gonna lose probably $1 billion+ because of the IPO, plus just losses in general. So, and it doesn't look like things will turn around any quick amount of time, like all of a sudden they're gonna go from losing tons of money to making profits or something like that. So I'm just saying, if you're also going to try to turn this trade into a long-term investment, you got to be a little worried, you know, you got to be a little wary there, because basically you're paying a nosebleed valuation for this company at this particular time, okay? Doesn't mean it can't work out long-term, but I'm just saying the valuation is really high on this one as of right now, all right? And here's the other thing you got to think about, okay? One of the other things you got to think about is Uber should be going public within the next month or two. Uber, and never mind that, there's other companies supposed to be going public sometime soon, Pinterest, Airbnb, I can guarantee you a lot of people are going to want that Airbnb public offering, okay? But needless to say, Uber is, in my opinion, the one that a lot of people really want, okay? Because Uber, you're getting a way, way bigger business, you know, a way more scalable business than where Lyft is at right now. Then you're getting Uber, you're getting a lot more business lines there and a lot more diversification around the world than something like Lyft. So if you're just kind of looking at it, what do investors really want a piece of, especially the big institutional investors? They really want that Uber IPO. So which means you could see even more money dry up out of Lyft and basically move to Uber whenever Uber comes public, probably within the next month or two, okay? So that's also something to think about. You basically, if you bought Lyft today on that open or anywhere near that open, you paid a nosebleed valuation, and you're also, you know, up against a situation that Uber is going to be coming public sometime soon, and most people want a piece of Uber rather than Lyft, okay? That's something we covered in the Uber versus Lyft video I did. I don't know, that was probably a few months ago. I did that video kind of comparing Lyft and where Lyft is at and with their numbers versus where Uber is at. And you're just going to find that Uber is a massively bigger company than Lyft, more diversified around the world. Also, Uber, just they announced they bought Careem out of the Middle East for about $3 billion this past week. That gives them even more diversification around the world. That's like the main player in the Middle East, okay? Never mind, you got Uber Eats, they're in the scooter business, the bike business, a lot of different things Uber has going on. So if you're just looking at this, you know, I can see a lot of investors wanting to invest in Uber rather than Lyft, because Lyft is kind of like the long shot. Yeah, maybe you could make some crazy money if they happen to take out Uber, but it's very unrealistic at this point in the game, guys. Very unrealistic. So, you know, don't buy into the media hype. You know, they're saying this was some type of super successful IPO and people are making all this money. No. A few made some money, the very select few, but all the regular folks are down massively on their shares right now. Massively, okay? Or they had a sellout for a huge loss today. That's the bottom line around this Lyft situation, guys. So don't buy into the whole, oh, this was such a great thing or something. No, it wasn't. It went bad for most folks out there who try to buy those shares today. It may be either to trade them or turn them into long-term investments. They're all lost money or they're all down massively, guys. So anyways, let me know what your opinion is on Lyft in that comment section. Also, would you rather buy Uber stock or Lyft stock? I want to hear from you guys in that comment section as always. Thank you for watching and have a great day.